Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing good. In today's video, we are going to discuss on time complexity of linear and binary search. But before going into that, I would like to describe what do we mean by time complexity. So it is the amount of time it takes to run an algorithm. So we estimate it by counting the number of operations an algo performs. Okay. Moving on to linear search. So we have already discussed in the linear search tutorial that for a particular item, we check each item one by one till either we find the item in the array or we reach the end of the array. So here we are traversing the length of the array. So the complexity is order of n, where n denotes the length of the array. I'm going to show you the example that we did previously in the linear search tutorial itself. I've just put one new variable, that is comparison. To check the number of comparison we are going to perform to get the searched item. So the number of values are 23 is found at position 5, and the number of comparisons that we perform for this single search is 5. So the time complexity is order of n, and n here is the length of the array, which is 5. Moving on to binary search. So in binary search, we discussed there are two important terms. Number one is array should be sorted, and we compare the particular item with the middlemost item of the array. And accordingly, if that particular item is more than the middlemost item, then we move to the upper half of the array, otherwise the lower half of the array. So I'll show the example that we did in the binary search tutorial itself. So I'm going to run that program. This program link you can find in the binary search tutorial. I have provided the GitHub link as well. So here we can see that this is my array element. I wanted to search for 1 of 2. So in the first comparison, I'm doing from the 0 to n minus 1. In the second, I'm moving to the upper half of the array. So lower bound is 4. And upper bound is 6, and I'm just doing the total comparison too, and I'm able to find the element at location 6. So we are going to derive the time complexity for binary search now. So I can see that after my first iteration, length of array is equal to n. This is my first iteration, after the first iteration. Now, after iteration 2, length of array is equal to n by 2. So, if I'm having an iteration 3, then length of array is equal to n by 2, and this whole divided by 2. So this is equal to n by 2 power 2. So after the iteration, if I have more iterations, then after iteration k, the length of array equal to n by 2 power k. And we know that after k divisions, length of array becomes 1. So n by 2 power k is equal to 1. So I can write it as n equal to 2 power k. Right? So I'm going to apply log function both sides, and then it is log, I'm going to put binary log, so log 2 n equal to log 2 to power k. So this will be log n equal to log, this is 2, and it will be multiplied by k. Now we know that this will become to 1, this one, no, excluding the k, that is log of a equal to 1. So using this property, I'm going to put it as 1, and then the value will be log n equal to k. So hence, the time complexity for binary search is equal to log of n. I hope you are able to understand the time complexity of linear search and binary search. I'm going to discuss about phase complexity and time complexity of other searching and sorting algorithms in my upcoming videos. If you have any concern or you want me to cover more topics, please put in the comment sections. I hope you like the video. Do subscribe to the channel. Thank you.